Please subscribe our channel Education Point and press bell icon to get notification of new educational videos.
Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 306, and today I am going to discuss the Arrhenius and Bronsted Lorry concept of acids and base. So the Arrhenius concept of acid and bases are based on the production of H positive and OH minus in the solution. If any substance which is dissolved or which is dissociated in the aqueous solution, if it gives H positive, then according to Arrhenius it is acid. And in aqueous solution, if the substance gives hydroxy ion OH minus, it means the substance is basic. So Arrhenius concept is only limited to aqueous solution, which are acid and base. And then the second concept is, that is Bronsted Lorry. And Bronsted was Danish chemist, and James Lorry was British, and they worked from 1875 to 1936 a lot on acid and base. So their theory is based on proton transfer. So any substance which accepts proton is acid, and the one which gives the proton is base. So it is based on proton transfer. And for example, if there is ammonia NH3 and that NH3 is dissolved in water, so you will get NH4 positive and OH minus. So here NH3 is going to gain the electron. So, the proton. So, once it is gaining the proton, it means it will be having base. So, ammonia will act as base, and NH4 positive will act as conjugate acid, and OH minus will act as conjugate base, and water will act as conjugate acid. And here this concept of conjugate acid and base is just because of losing and gaining of the proton, and that gives the conjugate acid base concept. And in the case of Arrhenius, what he gave, for example, if there is any substance HX and if in water it gives H positive plus X minus, so this in water aqueous, it is in aqueous, so it will be known as acid. And if anything like MOH, and if it gives OH minus plus M positive, so this OH minus means it is your base. So that is as per Arrhenius concept. And Lorry Bronsted concept is that if there is ammonia, for example, H3 plus H2O. So here, in this case, what you are getting, NH4 positive plus OH minus. So in this case, this one will be your base, this one will act as acid, and this one will act conjugate acid, and this one will act as conjugate base. This is as per the Lorry Bronsted concept. So all these I am going to explain one by one. So here Arrhenius acid base concept is given. Number one is, according to Arrhenius concept, an acid is a substance which dissociates to give hydrogen ion, that is H positive, when dissolved in water. An example is HX aqueous, and in water solution it will give hydrogen ion aqueous and X minus aqueous. And this HX, the same substance, when it is dissolved in water, actually H positive is not found in free state. It will be associated with one molecule of water, and that we call it that H positive will be hydrated, and that ion is known as hydronium ion, that is H3O positive aqueous plus X minus aqueous. So number two, the ion H3O positive is known as hydronium ion, and this species has been detected in many compounds. For example, H3O positive Cl minus in solid state. And number three, a base is a substance which ionizes in aqueous solution to hydroxy ion. The example is MOS. So MOS will be dissociated into M positive and OH minus in aqueous state. And here also, in aqueous solution, the hydroxy ion will not be free. It will be again associated with one molecule of water, and it is known as the hydroxy will be hydrated, and that it will give you H3O2 minus ion. So the hydroxy ion OH minus is also hydrated to give H3O2 minus ionic species. Number four, the Arrhenius concept was widely accepted. However, the concept has a serious limitation that it can be only applicable to aqueous solution. For other solvents other than water, it is not applicable. So this is the serious limitation of Arrhenius theory. So now I am giving here the Bronsted Lorry concept of acid base, and this concept is based on proton transfer. So according to this concept, any substance which donates the proton will act as acid, and the one which accepts the proton will act as base. And here there will be conjugate acid and base formation. It depends upon the proton availability, whether it is lost or it is gained, and that will be given in the form of conjugate acid base. The best example I am giving you here is ammonia, NH3 plus H2O. So in solution form it will be NH4 positive and OH minus. So NH3 here it will be as a base, but NH4 positive where one proton is added, so it will act as acid, a conjugate acid. And in the case of OH minus, where there is loss of proton, so it will act as conjugate acid. So this example I am giving here with this concept, Bronsted and Lorry concept. Number one, the concept is also known as proton transfer theory. This is also known as proton transfer theory because proton is transferred. If it is proton is donated, it will be acid. If it is accepted, it will be base. So this concept is applicable to aqueous as well as non-aqueous solution, because Arrhenius concept was limited to aqueous solution. But this Lorry Bronsted is having broad concept. It is not limited to only water. It can be applicable to aqueous solution as well as non-aqueous solution. Number two, the Danish chemist named J.N. Bronsted, and he worked in the year from 1874 to 1936. And another English chemist whose name was Thomas M. Lorry, he also worked from 1874 to 1936. They worked independently. One was Danish and other one was English. But they proposed this concept independently, but it was same. That's why it is combined term known as Bronsted and Lorry concept of acid and base. Number three, according to this concept, an acid is defined as a substance which has tendency to donate proton to other substance. Similarly, a base is a substance which has tendency to accept a proton from other substances. Number four, hydrochloric acid, that is HCl, acts as an acid when dissolved in water. It donates a proton to H2O and H2O molecule that act as base. So here, HCl gas, H2O liquid. It is H3O positive, means it has accepted the proton, and Cl minus will be there, and that's why HCl will act as acid, because it has donated one proton to water, and water will act as acceptor of proton. So the concept of proton transfer is also applicable to non-aqueous medium. For example, HCl gas, ammonia gas, and there will be formation of ammonium ion gas and chloride ion gas. Here HCl is Bronsted acid and ammonia is Bronsted base. For sake of clarification between Arrhenius and Bronsted concept, so NH3 aqueous plus H2O liquid equilibrium will be NH4 positive aqueous plus OH minus aqueous. So here NH3, there is addition of proton between this. So here addition of proton is there, and it will act as conjugate acid, and NH3 will act as base. Here water, there is loss of protons, so it will act as acid, and this one which is gaining the proton will act as conjugate base. So that's why there is conjugate acid and base concept here also. So here I am explaining the Bronsted and Lorry concept in this above reaction, where ammonia NH3 aqueous is base, water liquid is acid, and here NH4 positive aqueous is conjugate acid, and this one is conjugate base, and here this ammonia is responsible of adding the proton, and after the addition of proton it will become conjugate acid, and H2O is losing the proton, and that's why OH minus will act as conjugate base. Number one, in the above reaction, proton transfer takes place both in forward and backward direction. In the reverse reaction, proton is transferred from NH4 positive to OH minus. Here NH4 positive is Bronsted acid and OH minus is Bronsted base. The pair of an acid and base like H2 and OH minus, or NH3 and NH4 positive, which differ by only presence or absence of protons, and that is called conjugate acid base pair. So those are conjugate acid and base pair, they only differ in the absence or presence of proton. Number two, if the Bronsted acid is strong, then its conjugate base will be weak. And if the Bronsted base is strong, then its conjugate acid will be weak. So it is just, with a strong and weak conjugation. Number three, this is very interesting here. The species like H2O, HCO3 minus, HSO4 and ammonia can act both as Bronsted acid and base. So let us see here, two molecules of water, both water molecules are same, but one is acting as Bronsted acid and the other one is acting as Bronsted base, and it depends upon the losing or gaining of the proton. So in one case, water where the H3O positive is conjugate acid, and here H2O base, H2O base will act here conjugate acid, and that H2O acid be here as conjugate base. Same thing will happen to two ammonia molecule, acid base, where it is losing or gaining a proton, one will act as conjugate base, the other one will act as conjugate acid. So with this I will stop here with the concept of acid base given by Lorry, Bronsted, and in next lecture I am going to discuss Lewis acid and base with this. Thank you very much.